Stan Jabalisco here, whose body resides in the black holes of Dakota Territory, United States of Advertising, but whose mind resides someplace like this. Especially, I just thought of something kind of cool, though, that I thought you might like to look at if you haven't already done this kind of thing. It can be very, very entertaining and informative in some cases, too. Go to the Google Advanced Search. Not the basic search, but the advanced search, and type some kind of phrase in there, an exact word or phrase that you might like to see. One that sticks in my mind is a poem that we read way, way back in, I believe it was middle school, and I think it started out like, "The moon was a ghostly galleon." I thought this was one of the most epic poems ever composed. The Highwayman, that is the name of the poem. The moon was a ghostly galleon. I always imagine it as a crescent with its open end up. But in any case, the moon was a ghostly galleon, the Highwayman. The wind was a torrent of darkness among the gusty trees. The moon was a ghostly galleon tossed upon cloudy seas. The road was a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, and the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The highwayman came riding up to the old inn door. And all I remember was that it had to do with some girl that either he won or he lost. I don't know. It was a very long poem, as you can see, but you can just go do a phrase search on Google and do that. It reminds me of another thing. It was a song. It had to do with like a 52 Vincent and a red-headed girl or something like that. One of those kind of things that just, if you were from that era, you would be moved. Of course, this is a very much older poem. I guess I've got liberty to quote that much of it for the purpose of reviews. I certainly loved that poem, so I can't imagine how the proprietor of that poem would object to my reading it on my private YouTube channel. But that's one thing that you can do. I always get off on typing my own name. Well, the is the nerd, okay? Stan Jabalisco. Seeing as I'm just about the only Stan Jabalisco I know of on planet Earth, I get a lot of results, and they're all me. I've written some books, and look at that. Now, isn't that just about the most uncomplimentary picture you could ever ask for? Stephen Krantz, I know him. Mathematician, a very sharp guy indeed. I don't know him. I don't know him. Forrest Mims. I don't know him, but I have a tremendous amount of respect for him. He's sort of in the same field I am. Here's some of my books. But one of the cool things here, you get these images, like the doctored up one. Now, I don't know where the heck this thing comes from. I have no idea. Dakota yesterday, Stan Whiting, this has absolutely no connection to me. So that's, but at least I don't know who that guy was, but I'm not going to find out now. I'm not going to bore you with that kind of stuff, but it's all kind of interesting stuff when you start doing that. I wonder what would happen if I just hit Jabalisco, because there are other Jabaliscos on Earth. I've won first place in the Google rankings of the Jabaliscos on the planet Earth. Giuseppe Jabalisco, the famed pole vaulter from Italy, now has to take a back seat on Google to me. As for the pole vault, I doubt I could pole vault over a cockroach, but be that as it may, I have won. Oh, joy, joy. That just makes my whole day. And now that I've discovered that here in the black holes of Dakota Territory, United States of Advertising, I can retreat to my home where my mind resides in some violent spatial continuum where things happen beyond everybody's imagination, even mine. So long.